10th subject social science, and as you know that we discuss about chapter number 3 cultural heritage of India, sculpture and architecture. Before start today's sessions, just take a glance over that what we have done in the last videos. In the last videos, I think so we have discussed a 4 question answer, and that we'll revise once only. In that first one, what is Tukt and which are the famous Tukt built during the time of Ashoka? So as you know that a Tukt means, we can say that, an oval shape construction in which the body parts or remains of Lord Buddha's body parts were kept in a box, that is called Tukt. Now the famous Tukt which are built during the time of Ashoka are, you can say that, Stupa of Sanchi, Stupa of Sarnath, Stupa of Beral, Stupa of Ranjangarh, and the Stupa of Devni Mori, which is located in Gujarat. And that you must have to remember it, because maybe in exam they were asked in the MCQ also, which Stupa is located in Gujarat, which built during the time of Ashoka. So that is Devni Mori. The next one is that, describe or give the information about the Stupa of Sanchi. That is also, if you remember that we have written only 4 points, because these all are little small question answer. So Stupa of Sanchi, first of all we can say the Sanchi Stupa was built during the Mauryan period. You must have to remember the period, or you can say dynasties, which is given, because it is an important during whose time that has been constructed. So Mauryan period, and it is situated at Madhya Pradesh. So that is the, you remember two names, Mauryan period and Madhya Pradesh. It means MM, it means 2M, we can say Mauryan period and Madhya Pradesh. The original Stupa of Sanchi was made up of bricks. You know that it's constructed long ago, so it was constructed with the help of bricks. And we can say that it was half in size compared to the present stupa. This, a Buddhist stupa, is a precious specimen of art and architecture, because during that time, without any kind of technology, they have constructed the huge monuments, and that is why you can say that is the best example or best specimens of art and architecture. Next, that we have discussed about the give information about the pillar inscription, understood, or you can say stone inscription. So first of all, what is pillar inscription, what is stone inscription, that we must have to be remember. Pillar or stone inscription in the sense, during the time of Ashoka, or you can say the Ashoka had started this carving on the stone, or you can say wood or metal. Stone inscriptions carved by the religious order of Emperor Ashoka are the best specimens of engraving on stone, because he has started that to engraving on, or you can say carving onto the stones or wood. Now in that we have discussed about that a stone inscription were made from a single rock. If you remember that I have written the points and I have made the underline also. This all stone inscription were made out from the single rock. It looked like a chariot temple, means the rath temple, we can say. Now the stone inscriptions carved out by the religious order of Emperor Ashoka are the best specimens of engraving on stone. They were polished so well that, and student, that we discussed, they were polished so well that they gleamed or shined. The pillars were, you can say that, constructed in the places, for example, you can say Ambala, Meerut, Allahabad, Sarnath, Goria, Nandangarh, Sanchi. So these are the places where we can find that this pillar inscription or stone inscriptions. Now they were carved in a Brahmi script. This is the most asked questions in the examinations, right? In which script this pillar inscription was carved out? So the script was, you can say, used is that Brahmi script. Apart from this, the stone inscription at Sarnath, you know that the pillar stone inscription of Sarnath is one of the best specimen of the, you can say, King Ashoka sculptures. That on that pillar, you can say one tower pillar of stone, on top of these red pillars we find that 4 lions facing 4 directions, understood, and that is carved out from the single stone only, and the 4 lions facing 4 directions, and in the bottom of that these 4 lions we find that images of other animals like horse, bull, etc. And in middle of that, we find that Dharma Chakra. It indicates the, you can say that, Dharma Chakra that indicates the religious victories also. And that is why it is called the Dharma Chakra. And most probably that you find in the national flag also. Apart from this, we can say, we discuss about that, these specimens of cultures considered to be the base culture in the entire world. So students, here we have completed our revision part. It means what we have done in the last videos. Okay, now we start today's session. Now in today also we will take some of the question answer. And in that first one is that, why the Gupta period? Why Gupta period is regarded as golden period? Now this is a 2 months question, so at least we require 5 to 6 points, 1 year by 6 points as it is required. First of all, we can say that this Gupta period, during the Gupta period, architecture, sculpture, painting, dancing and music flourish. It means during the Gupta period, we can say the art was flourished. In the art, each and everything was included. For example, architecture, sculpture, painting, dancing, music, etc. was included in this. That is why I written the one word only, art, so you can remember the different art forms. Apart from this, we can say that this Gupta period regarded as a golden period because during the Gupta period, many temples were constructed. Even the, you can say, chaityas, stupas, viharas, mats, these all were constructed during the time of Gupta period. That is why it is also known as, regarded as a golden period, we can say. Now, another point is that about the art of Gupta period, or you can say a golden period, that which temple was constructed? Now we will take the examples of it. So first of all, we can say Parvati temple at Jabalpur, or you can say Minava. Okay, so this one steps you can write, so it is easy for you to remember the entire answer. Now Parvati temple, it is located at Jabalpur in Ninava. Then in Arans, Arans, we find that Narsi temple, that is the best example of it. It is also constructed during the time of Gupta period. After that we can say that Bhog Mandir at Jamnagar. Bhog Mandir at Jamnagar So these are the steps you must have to remember, place as well as that particular thing. So it is easy for you to write the answer. Next one is that, apart from this, a temples during the time of Gupta, stupas, chaityas, viharas, even you can say temples, mats, these all are constructed. That is why it is also regarded as a golden period. Apart from this, statue of, you can say Buddha, statue of Lord Buddha at, where we know that the statue of Lord Buddha is located at Sarnath, because it is one of the base specimens of this time. Statue of Buddha at Sarnath. So students, here I have written 6 points, so it is okay for that. But if you want to add it, so you can add one more point, is that the base specimen of sculpture of Gupta period is also as a statue. It means during the time of Gupta, the statue is also constructed at different places in our country. So students, here we have completed these 2 months questions, that Why the Gupta period is regarded as a golden period? So very simple, during the time of Gupta, or you can say during the time of Gupta period, art was flourished. In exam, you don't have to write the art word. Instead of that, you can write architecture, sculpture, painting, drawing, music, etc. was flourished during the time of Gupta. Now, next one is many temples, stoves, chaityas, viharas, mutts, etc. was constructed. Then after you give the example of it, Parvati temple, Jabalpur, you can say Minawa, Aaron's temple, Aaron's Narsi temple, Gop Mandir at Jamnagar, then stoop, chaityas, viharas, mutts, etc. was constructed during the time of Buddha, and the last one is statue of Buddha at Sarnath is the best specimen of this. Now students, we move towards another questions of today's. Now today's next question is that cave architecture. Give information about the cave architecture. Now here also it is also asked for 2 marks, so we require 5 to 6 points, and it's a very easy also. First of all, when you write or start the right answer of this cave architecture, cave in the sense student, it is called gufa in Gujarat, we can say gufa. So that architecture, because we know that in Gujarat or in throughout the India we find lots of number of caves in our country. So before start writing this answer, there is a best point of this answer is the question is that cave architecture is man-made place of beauty. Now students, you just see that we have written first point. Now students, here we have completed first point that cave architecture is a man-made place of beauty. In exam we can ask for MCQ also. Death is considered as a man-made place of beauty. So answer is the cave architecture. Now first you got that the you can say foundation. Now you just start writing the answer link wise. Cave architecture is a man-made place of beauty. Now you write about the caves which you know. First of all, for example, we know about the Ajanta and Ellora caves in Aurangabad. That we already know about this Aurangabad caves. Even Elephanta caves in Mumbai. That also you can write. So one by one you think about that, because that we have discussed in chapter number 6, Ajanta, Ellora and Elephanta caves. Understood? Apart from this, Bhubaneswari cave near Odisha, Bhubaneswari caves in Odisha. Here you just write about the name of the caves or place of the caves, and beside of that place, or you can say state which is located over there. Next one is that Khambalida caves. It is very proud of that. For that Khambalida, which is located in Gujarat and it is near to Bandal, Khambalida village. Apart from the Sana caves, you can say Taraja, caves of Khapra Ghodia, Kadia Dungar. So these are the names of the caves, you can write about that. But we have a separate questions of these caves of Gujarat. So it is better that we write only one caves about the caves of Gujarat, that is Khambalida caves. Apart from this, you can say that the cave inscription, the cave inscription of Ashok have been carved on the walls of three walls of Belvoir Mountain, or you can say Belvoir Mountain or Belvoir Hills also. Apart from this, cave of Sudama in Bihar and cave of Sita is the best specimen of the cave architecture. So here students, I have written two more questions, but I have written more than 6, 7 points or 8 points also, and it's a very easy to remember. You just see that first one is about the foundation of the answer is that cave architecture is the magnet place of beauty. Understood? Second one is that you know about that cave, you write first as early as possible. Present and Indora cave is located near the Aurangabad, you can see in Aurangabad district. Then Elephanta cave, which is located in Mumbai. Then Bhumeshwari cave in Odisha. Kambalida caves in Gujarat. Here not a limitation, you can write more caves of Gujarat also if you remember them. Then the cave inscription of Ashoka have been found on the three walls of the Belvoir Mountain, and the cave of Sudama in Bihar and cave of Sita is the best specimen of the cave architecture. So students, here we have completed this question of the cave architecture. Now we'll move towards the next question. Now students, our next question is that caves of Gujarat, and generally this question is asked for 3 marks because this question is somehow lengthy also, you can say. Now in the total 8 caves are there, so without forget you write detailed information of each caves, but simple one is that we can say that all the caves, name of the caves, location and when it was constructed, that 3 things is most important. Apart from this, you can write about the detailed location also, what are the specialty of the caves, but it is easiest way that to remember this question is that the name of the cave, place and when it was constructed, that is the things. So first of all, total 8 caves is there, so we will discuss one by one. First one is that caves of Junagadh. Now in caves of Junagadh, students, here you don't have to be confused, because in caves of Junagadh there are 3 groups of caves in Junagadh. There are 3 groups of caves in Junagadh, and first one is that caves of Baba Pyara group. First one is that caves of Baba Pyara group. Or you can say group of Baba Pyara caves also. Now, first of all, location, where is it located? This cave is located in a Baba Pyara village. These caves are located in Baba Pyara mud also, you can say. It is located near the Baba Pyara mud. So only one word we remember, that mud. Second thing is that, and most important, total 3 in this caves, Baba Pyara caves, there are in the 3 layers intersecting to each other at right angles, and total there are 16 caves. Out of them, 4 are in one line or first line, 7 in second line and 5 in third line. So total here you remember that what? Second thing is total 16 caves are there. They are intersecting to 3 layers. Understood? First of all, you remember the word 3 layers. Total 16 caves. How is it constructed? That is the most important thing. In first group, 4 caves, second, 7, okay, and the last one is that remaining all, it means 5. Understood, students? Now in Baba Pyara, you must have to remember only these 3 or 4 things, that caves of Baba Pyara, group of caves located near the mouths of Baba Pyara, and total these groups of caves are in 3 layers, and then total 16 caves are there. They are intersecting to each other, and in the first line there would be a 4 caves, second line 7 caves, and third line we have 5 caves. So students, here we have completed Baba Pyara, and most probably you can write about that it during 1st and 2nd century AD. Understood? These caves might be constructed at the 1st or 2nd century AD. So this is the first number. Then second number is that we not write about Ghumus, but we can say that during in Junagadh, the second number group of caves are that they will be in a double storage. You can say they will be in a double storage, and that might have been carved during the end of the 2nd century and the beginning of the 4th century. So these caves were also constructed during the time of 2nd and 4th century. Now, caves of Khapra area or caves of Kund. Here what happens, students? Here also fluorite caves, but here you can find that something is different. Here you can find the pillars. In second number only, double storied, and here's number C, there would be a pillars in the caves. Understood? So students, here we have completed that you can say Baba Vihara group of caves, or you can say first number of caves. Total 8 caves are there. So first number is completed. Now we move towards the second number, and that is already we have done Khambalida caves. Now students, you must have to remember that the place and name Khambalida caves is discovered in 1959. So what we need to remember, 1959, it is rediscovered. You must have to remember that discovered or rediscovered. It is a suitable that you must have to remember discovered in 1959, not rediscovered. We write about that only, discovered in 1959. Now location, where is the Khambalida caves are located? So very simple, Khambalida caves are situated near the Khambalida Gondal, 17 km away from Rajkot. So here three places you must have to remember. First one as it is Khambalida, second one is Gondal, and 70 km away from Rajkot. So two, and now the third one is that specialty of the Khambalida caves, or where it was constructed. So Khambalida caves, here we can find that in the entrance of the caves, that the devotees are standing beside of the cave, and these caves are also constructed during the 2nd and 3rd century, or you can say 2nd and 3rd century. Understood, students? So here we have completed second number of group of caves, that is Khambalida caves. Now next one is at Talaja caves. So Talaja caves. Now Talaja caves, here students, we not write too much information because total 8 group of caves are there in Gujarat. So if you write, you just imagine that if you write at least 2 or 3 points from each cave, so 8 is 24 points will be there. We not require that much point in 3 months questions. We require at least 10 to 12 points, not more than that. So now first and second we write in detail, that is the good thing. But now onwards, third onwards, we write about the where it was constructed and place only, not more than that. Now here the mountain of Talaja is situated near the mouth of the Setrunji river in Bhavnagar district. Now here we can say that what is the exact location of that this Talaja caves. It is located near the mountain of Setrunji, and or you can say Setrunji river in Bhavnagar district, mouth of the Setrunji river and Bhavnagar district. So students, here also we have written 3 points that Talaja caves are located near the mountain Talaja, and or you can say you don't have to write mountain here also. Now mouth of the Setrunji river near Bhavnagar district, and next one is that Bhavnagar district only. These 2 points is suitable for that. Now we will move towards the 4th number caves. And now the name is also too, you can say, difficult to remember. Fourth one is that Sana caves. about each cave. This group of caves is situated on the top of Sada Mountain in Vankia village. Okay, top of Sada Mountain in Vankia village. If you want to write differently as a point, you can also, and if you write one more point, that is also you can do it. Understood. But Una Taluka, Gir Somnath district. These caves are spread on Sada Mountain like in beehive. Understood. So you must have to write this point because students, you know that whenever any characteristics or special thing is given, you must have to be right, because in exam they ask the MCQ from that only. They ask the objective from that only. So this mountain is spread over the Sada Mountain in the you can say shape of beehive. Now that is over. Next one is that fifth number is Dhan Caves. Now Dhan Cave. Now here only 2 points we will write about that. So Dhan Giri is situated in a Dhan village of Upleta Taluka at Rajkot district. Now Upleta Taluka, first point, Upleta Taluka Rajkot district. These caves are constructed during the 4th century. That is also over. Understood, students? So here 4th number and 5th number also we have completed. These are the names of caves and what is the specialities that we have written, not more than that. Now up to 5 number we have completed. Now we move towards the 6, 7 and 8. Now number 6, and that is the Jinjurijar. That is very difficult name. Jinjurijar. Jinjurijar caves. Wait a minute. Jinjurijar caves. The name is also typical. So there are many Buddhist caves in this west of Dhan, about 7 km from Sidsar, is the valley of Jinjurijar. It is considered that they have been built in the 2nd century. So here students, one only point to remember, that it was constructed during the 2nd century. Understood? Now only one point. Or if you want to write about that, so it is 7 km away from the Dhan caves, we can say. Next one is Khabra Kudia caves at Kutch. Khabra Kudia. Khabra Kodia cave at Kutch, and that is the famous caves also, we can say. These caves are situated on the top of the mountain near Old Patghat in a Lakhpat Taluka of Kutch. So here we get one point, is that Lakhpat Taluka Kutch district. So one point we get that location. Now second point is about their speciality. There are two caves. These are discovered by K.K. Sastri in 1967 AD. Only we can write about that. Two caves discovered by K.K. Sastri in 1967. You just see this. Only 2 points you have written. The Khabra Kudia cave is located on the top of the mountain, the Lakhpat district, Taluka, Kutch district. And second is that two caves are there and discovered by the K.K. Sastri in 1967. Now student, last number of cave is that caves at Kadia Dungar. Caves of Kadia Dungar. Now number 8. And you know that if we write 2 points of each cave, so we just remember 8 to 16 points is there, so already it is enough for that. Now there are 3 caves in Kalia Dungar and Jagadia Taluka in Bharuch district. So here we get that, yes, first of all, Jagadia Taluka, Bharuch district. And if it is specialty is there, then we can mention about that. But if it is not there, then we can leave work here only. Now, architecture of this caves is marvelous and 11 feet high statue. Here, the specialty is there. So, we write about that. 11 feet high statue of lion. And the, what is the specialty of this statue? You know the students, this lion has only one body but two mouths. Understood? That is why it is, and that is carved out from the single rock. That is the specialty of this thing. Now, so here students, we have completed number 8 caves also. Understood? Kaya Dungar caves. So students, today we have completed, you know that the why Rupta period regarded as a golden period. Second one is that architecture, cave architecture. Third one is that caves of Gujarat. So please write carefully about each and every worksheet which you got. Keep in the safe condition, because maybe in the next month you will be having another exam. And please send your homework in the given regular time limit. Thank you, students.